As a minimalist and digital minimalist, my setup is extremely clean from a UI standpoint. So everything from Google Calendar to the left here is all that's on my taskbar. So on the desktop, as you can see, these are the only apps I have. And honestly, I don't even like click on these much. I could, if I wanted to, probably get rid of the majority of these. But the reason I keep them on there is just to have something on the page. I don't believe in having things that aren't going to move you forward regarding your productivity or getting things done on the homepage. Anything that would be a distraction is just not on the homepage. I honestly only think I'd need the recycle bin here, if I really am being honest, because I usually just type Photoshop in the bottom left when I'm working on something else, or Premiere in the bottom left and stuff like that. But it's nice to have something on the desktop in general. So moving down to the taskbar though, I do have what I usually end up interacting with here, and that is obviously Notion, the File Explorer, Brave, which is my web browser, and Google Calendar. So actually diving right into Brave here, as you'll see, it has this amount of ads blocked in the time that I've used it and supposedly this much bandwidth saved. It has a built-in ad blocker, which is really nice, so I don't have to have that on top of the other extensions that I have. But essentially, Google Chrome is worse than this, in my opinion, because Google Chrome just takes up an inordinate amount of RAM on your computer, and this takes up less and has all the same extensions because Google Chrome is just a version of Chromium, which is actually the main browser functionality that this uses as well. And then some quick stuff I'll talk about with this is there is a nice extension that I use called the Great Suspender. And the Great Suspender original is this application that I use, which essentially allows me to have things that are, as you can see here, I can press suspend this now. And what happens is this takes that application and suspends it and saves the RAM. So this actually defaults to, if we go to the settings, I can suspend tabs after 10 minutes, every 20 seconds after not using it, or whatever amount of time not using it. And you could also choose whether it's a light or a dark mode. So if I were to, for example, if I were to suspend this tab, it would change from light to dark mode, depending on what I chose. And it's a very nice and simple and easy to use application that's huge for me. And I also have Dark Reader on, so the majority of times when I'll go on a web page, I'll just, it'll usually just be in dark mode, which I personally like and appreciate. Then obviously the next thing that I have on this bottom part here is Notion and my good old evergreen Notion workspace, which I interact with on a daily basis. And obviously that's what I'm going to use. So that's why it's on this taskbar, because it's always going to be there. And I love having the four main things that I utilize pinned on here. This is my Google Calendar. I always have this on the bottom taskbar because it's really nice to not have to go back and forth between things. And as you'll notice, what I don't have here, I don't have email because I only want to check it at certain times of the day. I don't want to get distracted. I only want to respond to emails every once in a while. So that's why that's not on the taskbar as well. And then another app that I really enjoy is Cold Turkey Blocker. And this is similar to an app called Freedom, if you've heard of it, which is just a application that prevents me from seeing things. So for example, YouTube analytics, I look at this stuff too much. So if I press off, what this does is this locks this so that I can't go to these websites. And there are website exceptions to these as well. But what this essentially does is it can have ones that are temporary where I can turn it on and turn it off, or for this case, I have it locked from 4 a.m. to 5 p.m. every day, and the only time I'm allowed to unlock it is after 5 p.m. and before 4 a.m. So basically during the working time, I can't look at my YouTube analytics on my computer. And then moving forward from that, I usually log off after 5, so this just ends up always being on. I'm very seldom able to get into that. And this is a nice way to prevent yourself from getting into other distractions too. This is an example of things like Tumblr, Reddit, Skype, and this could be something that I could turn on. And the option to have it locked would be what I just showcased you with the time range. You could have a timer on it. There could be a password set to it if you have a pro version, but I personally enjoy having this time range set to lock as well. Now from an aesthetic standpoint, you're probably questioning, what the heck is this over here? So I use something called Wallpaper Engine, which I'm a fan of. Wallpaper Engine is one of my favorite applications, as it is actually kind of a gamer application where most people use it for like cool backgrounds and whatnot. And I like to have it because the aesthetics of your computer matter whatnot. This is a cool background, but what I have it set to is actually it goes through this playlist at a certain amount of time. I believe I have it set to change every 30 minutes randomly between these. And you can see that they're just some minimalist backgrounds with you know, basic stuff going on. I'm a big fan of these overall, and back when I used to want other backgrounds, I have other playlists. Like, there's a bunch of space ones that I really enjoyed. Like, this one's pretty hype. I like this one a lot. And it's not something I work on too often, but it's just fun to have a playlist of different things going. Like, if I wanted to switch to my space playlist, I could go back to that and it have these look like this again. But I personally enjoy my minimalist playlist out of all of them the most, as I'm a digital and physical minimalist. And this was my background itself, actually. For a year and a half straight, I only had this one going, but it's a few bucks on the Steam store and is one of my favorite apps out there.
If you guys like this video, make sure to click on this one to see how you can improve your productivity even more.